Namaste, Kalyanji. Thank you so much for coming out to Waves this year. What was unique about this conference experience for you?
What was unique about this? Well, I think just the opportunity to be with a group of people who are seriously investigating various aspects of our Hindu culture, traditions, etc., and learning from each other was very, it's a great opportunity, you know, because like-minded people gathering together is a wonderful thing. So there's no such platform in the world, really. You know, I've been to many conferences related to my professional career. You know, I often go to Las Vegas for these mega conferences, you know, 20,000 people, technology conferences. But like a conference on Vedas is a very, very unique opportunity, I think. So it brings together people who are fairly serious, not just shopping or something, you know. So in that sense, it was very, it's a very good conference.
So how was your topic that you presented in the panel and the paper that you presented? How did that go for you?
Well, actually, there were two different panels. So I presented on one panel, and then I chaired another panel. So let me speak about my presentation. So I had been working on for about a year on a kind of an assessment of the research work launched by one Dr. Professor S.N. Balagangadhara Rao in Ghent University. So the work that he had done over about 40 years. So I profiled it, I investigated it, I challenged it to some extent, but also represented it, and also worked with many scholars who are working with him or who are inspired by him. So I spent 4 days in Ghent University in his house talking to him. I went to dinner with many of his students. I met in Bangalore with his research group, and you know, we spent a couple of days in fact just reviewing their work. So it was a very comprehensive piece of work. I'm actually very proud of what I did. And after, over the course of 1 year, I wrote this document. In fact, I have a copy of it. I'd love to give it to you. But you have to read it, though. That's the only commitment I expect from you. Now, so that was my presentation. Independent of that, I chaired another session where there were other four other speakers. So we dealt with a number of different topics related to Hindu studies. You know, so one gentleman presented on the sound acoustic principles behind the design of a Hindu temple. So it was a very interesting study. So he was looking at the geometry of the Garbhagraha, the inner sanctum, and then the Ardhagraha, the outer sanctum, and then the outer, still outer compound, and what is the acoustic principles on which it is based. So that was a very interesting topic. I mean, I had never heard about it before. So another person was from Hindu American Foundation. So he was talking about the work that he was doing on the, in dealing with the United States Commission on International Religious Freedom, USCIRF. And how USCIRF, when it talks about religious freedom, they really mean the freedom to convert others. And when India passes laws that try to block the free conversion of Hindus into Christianity, the United States government considers that a violation of religious freedom. So in this whole conversation, the freedom of the Hindus to remain Hindus is not even on the table. Very fascinating. So, and he was talking about how that was difficult and what sort of challenges they were facing. And I thought that was a very important discussion. And like that, you know, a couple more papers that were very interesting papers. Yeah.
Well, that's fascinating that you were able to be a part of such interesting panels and research that's going on. Thank you so much for all the work that you do. Thank you so much for coming, and namaste.
Can I have one last word?
Yes.
Yeah, I think one very important thing for these kinds of conferences to be successful and impactful in the future is that we need a lot of young people to come and join these events, you know. And one concern I would say is that most of the people are getting older, and little bit more elderly. They want to go back to their roots after a long career in other professional disciplines. I'm not excluding myself in that category. But it'd be great to see people like yourself getting more involved and bringing a group. So think about what we can do to stimulate interest in the younger generation. I think that's very important. All right? Thanks so much.
Namaste.
Very nice. Namaste.